It's Wednesday, December 5th. I'm Emily Walsh.
And I'm Alex Mahanavan, here to report the daily headlines. Manatee County schools report more shocking budget omissions. An analysis led by Interim Superintendent David Gaylor has revealed the district omitted an additional $7 million in spending from this year's budget. A proposed 1% bonus for district employees was left out of the budget, as were expenditures such as utility bills, compensation for teachers who work with students after hours, and transportation for students to athletic events. Gaylor has an initial plan to offset some of the costs, but the district will still need to find more than $5 million to give bonuses promised to employees. Former Manatee County School Superintendent Tim McGonigal resigned in September after revealing the district was facing a $3.4 million deficit. For more on this story, go online to yourobserver.com.
Sarasota County has settled out of court with a software company. Tuesday, County Commissioners approved a $200,000 settlement to CSDC Systems, Inc. to avoid further legal costs. CSDC was hired in 2003 to implement land management software. Its contract was voided after competitors sued because the county never put the contract out for bid. Meanwhile, the county continued to use CSDC's software, prompting CSDC to sue for copyright infringement. CSDC has been presented with a new $2.6 million contract to replace a failed contractor on an information technology upgrade.
An audit of Sarasota County Area Transit uncovers weakness in its systems. The audit discovered poorly angled security cameras and staff members with too much monetary oversight. It also uncovered poorly managed purchasing contracts, which has led to thousands of dollars in lost grants. But despite department shortcomings, commissioners are considering a $7.4 million contract towards bus cleaning and mechanical work, parts and batteries, and adding 17 clean diesel buses. The county is also considering options to turn 5 new buses into trolleys for county islands, including Siesta Key, which would cost as much as $68,000 per bus.
Longboat Town Manager Dave Bullock has put the Colony Beach and Tennis Resort Association on notice. Bullock says the town expects further upgrades to the rundown property to make the outward appearance acceptable by Longboat Key standards. PZ&B Director Robin Meyer noted deficiencies including irrigation, landscaping eyesores, broken glass doors, and units that have been broken into. Colony Beach and Tennis Resort Association President Jay Yablon says he's glad the town has brought the issues to its attention and added the issues will be resolved. For more, pick up a copy of today's Longboat Observer.
A teen entrepreneur is on the verge of surpassing $1 million in sales. 2 years ago, Sam Vrinio started Imagine Customs, which retrofits and customizes Xbox 360 game controllers. The business started out of his parents' garage, but now operates out of a storefront in a Lakewood Ranch shopping plaza. Soon, the storefront in Lakewood Ranch will be open for retail. The business is currently online at imaginecontrollers.com. Read more about Sam and his business in this week's East County Observer.
Now here's Danae with your Daily Dealio.
I'm Danae DeShazer, and here's your Daily Dealio. Get your culture on with 2 tickets to the Venice Theater. Enjoy live theater this holiday season with an array of performances at the Venice Theater. Whether you want a musical comedy, a perfect girls' night out, a holiday concert, or riveting drama, you've come to the right place. There are 5 different concerts, plays, and musicals to choose from. Get 2 tickets for $25 at thedealio.com or visit us on Facebook at facebook.com/observerdealio.
Hey Alex, weren't you in a play at Venice Little Theater?
I was in How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying, and it was a ton of fun. That's all for today's daily headlines. For more community and breaking news, go online to yourobserver.com daily.
And pick up a copy of the Longboat and East County Observer Wednesday and the Sarasota Observer and Pelican Press Thursday.
You.
Your neighbors.
Your neighborhood.